When working with code, you will inevitably need to work with many types of variables. Ultimately, all variables have what is called a data type. The two primary data types are value types and reference types. Variables like integers, floats, doubles, booleans, and characters are all value types. Additionally, there are complex variable types known as structs. Structs are value data types that simply contain one or more other variables. The two most common structs in Unity are Vector3 and Quaternion. The list of reference types is much simpler. Basically, any variable that is an object of a class is a reference type. The two most common classes are thus the two most common reference types in Unity, Transform and GameObject. You might be wondering what the difference is between value and reference types. Simply put, value type variables actually contain some value. All reference type variables contain a memory address where the value is stored. The result is that if a value type changes, only that specific variable is affected. If a reference type changes, however, all variables that contain that memory address will also be affected. As an analogy, consider this. Charles has a nice blue house full of his favorite things. Quentin sees Charles' house online and is jealous, and so makes an exact copy and fills it with duplicates of everything that Charles owns. Creepy, right? This is like a sign made for value types. You make a copy of the variable. Quentin doesn't own Charles' house, and nothing he changes in his house will affect the original, not even painting it red. If Quentin had Charles' address, he wouldn't need to copy the house. He could simply visit anytime he likes and see its content instead. This is like assignment for reference types. You make a note of the memory address of the value you need and return to that address when you need to know the value of the variable. Let's take a look at this in action. We have here a scene with our friend Samaflange in it. Samaflange has a script named DataTypes script attached to him. Inside the DataTypes script, we first create a Vector3 variable named CurrentPosition and assign to it the value of the transform's position. We then set current position equal to a new Vector3 with a value of 0, 2, 0. Since we know that current position is a Vector3 struct and that structs are value types, we know that only current position is affected by this line of code. The transform's position is unaffected. If we go back into Unity, we can run our scene and confirm that Samaflange does not move. Value types contain their own copy of data, and changing them only affects that specific variable. Back in the data type script, let's try another approach. Let's start by creating a transform variable named tran and setting it to equal the object's transform. Then, let's set transposition to a new Vector3 with a value of 0, 2, 0. Since transform is a class, we know that tran is a reference type. Furthermore, since we assign the object's transform to the variable tran using the assignment operator, we know that they point at the same memory address. The result is that changing one changes the other. Back in Unity, we can run our scene. We should notice immediately that Samaflange has moved upwards, even though we never directly changed the value of Samaflange's transform. We were able to indirectly change it by using a reference variable.